Hello, viewers and listeners. Thank you once again for joining me on DMAF TV. Please don't forget to subscribe if you're coming here for the first time. If you're regular, just do the usual. Please like and comment. Also, share our videos so that others may also see what we do here. Because what we do is we give you current affairs in real time. So, yes, I've just gotten information from the Herald. I copied from the Herald, a tweet from the Herald, and they're saying Fountain Levels and Dama have been sentenced. The sentence has been passed. The court case was heard yesterday and the judge reserved the judgment up to today. So the judgment has been passed and they were sentenced to 1 year in prison. Papi Wagore Varimkati, but 6 months was suspended and 6 months remained effective. So this necessarily means that Fountain Levels and Dama are going to spend an effective 6 months in jail. This is as a result of violating COVID-19 regulations. They held a gig near Matapi police station where 4 police officers have also been arrested in connection to the same incident. So this effective means almost 10 people or more have been arrested in connection with the same gig. And I must say this, that the pressure to arrest these people, these alleged culprits, came from the people, the media. They were really pressuring, asking why the gig was held in the first place. Why police? I am told the gig was 100 meters away from Matapi police station. So people were complaining, good, why are you arresting? You are arresting. I am told the Winky D and Japres show was cancelled the first time because of COVID-19. But why did the police, the Matapi police, not stop the gig? Why was it allowed in the first place? So in response to that, the police has effectively arrested the trio of Fountain Levels and Dama, who were the headliners of the incident. And I am told more than 1,000 cases have emerged from the same gig. I must say this, guys, COVID-19 is real. Please, please mask up. Please practice social hygiene. Please sanitize your hands, wash your hands with soap for 30 seconds. For this 30 seconds, it's very, really, really, really necessary. I must also share this also, that I am told that my mathematics O-level teacher just succumbed to this deadly virus this very morning. And it's actually true, guys. So the warning is, please do mask up. Please do mask up. I've seen also a post from Nyarazo, Yangechita Urayoguti, home is better than ICU. It's better to be home than to be in the ICU. Ukaona even Nyaradzo yakuposta such things, some things of preventing death. It means kuti really va wandirwa nebasa and they can't take no more. I am told private hospitals and public hospitals alike are full of COVID-19 patients, and most of us I know, we do not afford personal ventilators. Sana kila zivu vanobuda vachibrega kuti we have got these ventilators and you also need them. Why, where can Jake and Jill get one ventilator? Where can they even think of getting a ventilator? It was really insensitive on the part of Kila Zivu, especially given that he is an MP in a constituency like former MP in a constituency like Chivi, where people really struggle to make ends meet, and to tell those people that you really need a personal ventilator, it's really kwakutopenga kwakutoita vanhu ivavo munhu iyeye. In fact, I think those are some of the reasons why he was expelled from the party, even though he is still doing some hero worshipping to try and be retained in the party. It's not good at all. What he said was insensitive and should be condemned, to say the least. It should be condemned. Pamwe pacho zvinhu zvacho zvavanenge vachitaura zvinotosha kuti vanofunga here? Ngakwana kila, ngakwana. So that's what I have for now. Please don't forget to mask up. Don't forget to social distance. Don't forget also to sanitize. Above all, don't forget to subscribe. Thank you so much.